Rockets existed long before Robert Goddard,
but they weren't powerful enough to get to space. We began to understand why around the turn of the 20th century. First, Russian physicist Konstantin Tsiolkovsky defined the physics of a rocket that could get to space. Then Robert Goddard set out to actually build it. Goddard meticulously studied every aspect of rocketry in school. In 1914, he patented his first designs for liquid fuel and two-stage rockets. With his own money, he started testing every rocket he could find. He tested solid-fueled fireworks, flares, and even Congreve rockets, the kind mentioned in the Star-Spangled Banner. Goddard found that these solid-fuel rockets were only converting about 2% of their fuel into actual thrust. The rest was just dead weight. So he took a part from the steam engine, the De Laval nozzle, and attached it to these rockets. This changed everything. By the end of the year, Goddard was able to increase the efficiency of his rockets to 63% in static tests. Goddard had finally achieved the sort of efficiency he needed to reach space with his rocket, but he wasn't even sure if it would work when it got there. So Goddard built a vacuum chamber and tested this with a variety of different rockets and nozzles. Soon, he found that without the friction of the atmosphere, rockets would actually work better in space. Goddard's experiments were getting expensive, too expensive for his own teaching salary to cover. So he reached out to the Smithsonian Institute for help. Skeptical of his claims of space travel, they asked to see his research. Soon, they received a leather-bound manuscript with this title embossed in gold, A Method of Reaching Extreme Altitudes. Within an hour of it landing on the desk of Dr. Charles G. Abbott, he enthusiastically called it the best presentation of a research project he had ever seen. Goddard was awarded a grant of $5,000. He went wild with ideas. He speculated about landing on the moon and even interstellar travel. But before Goddard could put any of this money to good use, the U.S. entered World War I, and Goddard went to work for the war effort. Stay tuned next week for part two. Thank you so much for watching. My name's Tim. I'm the editor and animator behind these videos. If you like what you saw, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. It really helps us out. Also, if you want to be notified next time a new video comes out, hit the bell next to it. If you'd like to help me make more videos, check Kinematic out on Patreon and lend a buck or two if you can. Thanks again for watching, and remember to share some space.